PPH stapler. PPH means procedure for prolapse and hemorrhoid. What prolapse? Mucosal prolapse of the rectal mucosa and hemorrhoid. What is hemorrhoid? Hemorrhoid is vascular cushion which is present in everyone. We have vascular cushion. But it is above the dentate line in the soft area of the ischiorectal part. But due to any reason, due to attenuated support, due to long standing, due to constipation, coughing, any mass, any abdominal mass, it gets pushed down. And once it comes at the level of a sphincter, now it started dilating because of insult of mucosa with the solid stool. And it started dilating and that is started bleeding and that is called hemorrhoid. Now traditional surgery is what? Traditional surgery is that you will take a band, apply the band or cut the hemorrhoid or do the Doppler or burn it by laser or cut it by harmonic is also used, ligature is used. But we are working on the hemorrhoid. In this surgery what you do? That you don't work on the hemorrhoid, you work on the mucosa. And you will make a purse string suture and you will do mucosectomy. And once you make a purse string all around the above the hemorrhoid, then the blood supply of the hemorrhoid is also cut and mucosal anastomosis will happen that will pull the vessels up. So basically it is called as hemorrhoidopexy. It is not hemorrhoidectomy. Even if you can tell hemorrhoidectomy is also a synonym, but actually it is a hemorrhoidopexy, which is pulling it up. And this is a very beautiful procedure compared to other procedure. Why? Everything you are doing above the dentate line, so pain is not there. Because there is no nerve ending, pain nerve ending in the mucosa. So there is no pain. Another advantage is that patient has faster recovery, early discharge, early return to work, and cosmetically better. Cosmetically better means what? Cosmetically, who will see the anus? What is the cosmesis there? But why cosmetically better? Because prolapsed mucosa is retracted up. So after the surgery, when you do conventional surgery, a stump is there. Surgery is easy, but when patient go to the toilet and he defecate after surgery, he feel like passing broken glasses. And he has to use silge bath, a lot of ointment, painkiller. Here, all the prolapsed mucosa is retracted up. So once patient go and touch the tissue paper, he will be surprised where his all the material has gone. There is nothing there, no stump. It will be completely retracted up. This is one of the big advantages of the surgery. I will show you just the beginning and the end of the surgery, how it looks like. So, if you will see here, this is the beginning of the surgery. Can you see? This is the beginning. And end I will show you. Once surgery is performed, this is the end. Let us see the end mode. You retract with the thumb. With the hand, see? Nothing, as if he born like this. Even if you do by finger, it doesn't show anything. And in the beginning, see, this is the beginning. This effect, none of the surgery can give, except PPH stapler. Because it is basically a hemorrhoidopexy. And it has a complete physiological correction. So what is actually happening? That all the prolapsed hemorrhoid is pulled up once you do mucosomucosectomy and a donut will come out, mucosal donut will come out and nothing, even the mucosa is pulled up, skin is pulled up no pain because above that quicker return to work. So if you will compare, this is after surgery, this is before surgery. This is how it works. So what you need to do is, you have to use the PPH gun. So that I am going to demonstrate to you. This is the proximate PPH stapler. Two companies are making, Ethicon and Covidian. Cost is how much? Approximately 18,000 rupees, single use. Single use, 18,000 rupees. But if you want economical, it is also available. I will show you how to buy it economical. You can get it for $25 only. And that is by the Alibaba.com. This is the website, one of the largest websites. You know, the owner of the Alibaba is the richest person of China, as you might be knowing. So, and it is authentic, it's not a scam website. PPH stapler, if you will get it, you get very economical. Alternatives are there. See here, it is so much, you can buy a set of 1,000 piece also. And one piece is $20. So if it is $1 to 100 set, you have to buy minimum 100, and then they are very economical. And it is same. We have tried. High quality, it works exactly similar to Ethicon. So, and you know, if you are buying for your personal use, up to, in India the rule is that any online purchase up to 30,000 rupees, there is no custom. So you don't have to pay the custom also. Directly by the DHL, by credit card, you can import. Pardon? No, all are non-reusable. That's why you need less expensive. So it has different parts I am going to demonstrate to you. Once you will open it, then inside it is completely ETO2 and gamma sterilized. It has five parts. This is called dilator. This is obturator. This is anoscope. This is suture puller, or you can say knot, pulling the knot. And this is the gun. Here is the main gun. This is circular stapler. This gun has two parts. One is anvil, another is gun. So this part is anvil here. And there is a knob, once you will rotate anti-clockwise, anvil is coming out from the gun. But this anvil cannot be detached. In the proximate circular stapler of colorectal surgery, anvil is detachable. Here also Covidian variety, anvil is detachable. But Ethicon variety, it is not detachable. Now if you see here, at this point, there is a lock. If anvil is fully out, or if it is even the less out like that, you cannot fire it. And if you want to open this lock, you cannot open it. Do you know why? Because this gap should be only 3 millimeters. So once you make it nearer, then you will see there is one indicator. Can you see the green color? If this green is visible in the indicator, then only this lock can be opened. If the green is not visible, if it is away, then this lock will not open. So you have, why this is safety feature? Now the lock can be opened. Why this is safety? Because it has staples. And if you will take muscle also, full thickness, rectum also, or you have taken hemorrhoid also in between, and then if the gap is more like that, and then if it will fire, it will make a shape of a C. It will not make a shape of a B. Just like a paper stapler made for 5 paper and you are stapling 50 paper, it will make a shape of a C. It will not go and bend. It has 2 jaws. If you see on the anvil, there is a face jaw. You will see there are grooves there. Can you see the grooves? These grooves are just like the grooves which is in the lower jaw of paper stapler to bend the staple. And this side has a groove for staples. Can you see the holes there? And there is a blade in between. Here, this blade. So this blade is cutting and these are stapling. So it is important that you should be in the safety line. That's why if you will see here, they have made a shape of a B. If you see, this is a good B, this is a bad B. Can you see that? Here is a shape of a B. This B is bad, that means your thickness is more. This B is good, that means your thickness is good, less. And if there is no B, means indicator is not in between, that means it is a C. So before firing, you should must see this indicator. And company has also given one precaution that there is a safety lock which will not open unless the indicator is in the green line. This gun has also 2 holes. This hole, one hole is this side, one hole is other side. To pull the suture from within, pull the suture from within so that you can tighten. How it works actually, that once you make a purse string like that, then this purse string anvil is pulling, all the hemorrhoid will go and it is catching the mucosa all around like that. And then it will hold your mucosa just like how it is holding my skin. So if you see here, I am holding like that and see, it is holding my skin. And if I will fire it, it will cut my skin and a staple also. So excess of the skin which is entering into will cut out and it will stitch also, stapled also. So that way it is making all around the hemorrhoidopexy. So this is the gun. So let us start the surgery, how it goes. That you have to push this dilator with the obturator and then take a couple of stitches to fix the obturator, and this is an anoscope. Now with the anoscope, you will start taking a persisting suture above the pious mass over the healthy mucosa. You will not take on the hemorrhoid, it should be above the pious mass over the healthy mucosa. And after that, you will check it. You may tie a knot here and then you will put a gun. Once you introduce the gun, the anvil will pull all the excess mucosa in this cup. Excess mucosa will go in the cup and then it will be stapled. See, all the hemorrhoid and excess mucosa is entering into this cup. And then anvil will lock it into the cup and mucosomycosectomy and mucosomycosal anastomosis will occur. Now remove it and surgery is over. So this is very good, easy, cosmetically better, less pain, and you can perform it. Now let us see how to perform the surgery. Patient should be in the lithotomy position. After that, there are 2 positions actually. One is jackknife position and other is lithotomy. What is jackknife position? Prone position with the 2-3 buttock pillow below the, so that the buttock will be in front of you. French people, they do jackknife. We are not comfortable with jackknife, so we do lithotomy. You can do under local, under spinal also. General anesthesia is not required. So you will put the dilator couple of times. It is dilated. After that, put obturator and take a bite with the buttock skin. so that fix it. This is important here. One thing is important, that this obturator which is there, once you fit it into the anus, first couple of time dilate it by finger, then you put this to dilate, and then attach both together and put it, and then take it out. Now it is important that this should not be half in and half out like this. Do you know this is 4 centimeters? It is important that this should be above the dentate line, all the dentate line it should cross. So buttocks should be fully spreaded, so that it should go as deep as possible. It should not be protruded like that half. So this is important. So push it completely deep, and all the hemorrhoids should come inside this cup, and then tie the 4 knot through the holes there and suture it. This is just a stay suture. This is just to keep it in the position so that it will allow you to perform the surgery. This is silk. This will be cut later at the end of the surgery, and you should fix it. Tight it nicely, it should not be loose, all the 4. All the hemorrhoids should come into the way. After that, this is 4th one. Patient should have good relaxation. In a spinal also relaxation you will get. That's why local is avoided, because in local the patient has tight muscle. Actually, what is external hemorrhoid? Prolapse, internal hemorrhoid is external hemorrhoid. So it can be for internal and external both, but it should not be a skin tag. It should be a real hemorrhoid. After that, once all the 4 is done, then you take anoscope and introduce the anoscope. This is anoscope. And start taking a purse string suture from 3 o'clock position. You retract the mucosa away. Here we are using the light source of the telescope to show you in. This is very good. This is light source, light cable with the light source of laparoscope. That will give you good vision. And take a needle, that is 22 mm needle. These are hemorrhoid. You have to take a bite above the hemorrhoid on the healthy mucosa. They give you proline with the 22 mm needle, and with the proline and with the needle you will take a bite. Slowly, this is the only mucosa, submucosa, no muscle should be taken. Only mucosa, submucosa, and take it out and again take a bite. Now, most of the mistake happens here. At a time of taking a bite, what are the mistakes I would like to point out? What are the mistakes which we do in the mucosa? Because for surgeon only this is the step which you have to do. Rest of the surgery is automatic by the stapler. For us, only thing is left is what? To take a purse string. What are the mistakes we do? Mistake number 1. Suppose this is the mucosa and we are taking a bite. What is the mistake? Less number. We have taken only 1 bite here and 1 bite here and 1 bite here. 3. Total 7 bites should be there. Better. 3 o'clock, 5 o'clock, 7 o'clock, 9 o'clock, 11 o'clock, 1 o'clock, and again 3:30. So how you will do that? You will see that you start from 3, come out, again go to 5, come out at 6, again you go to 7, come out at 8, again you go 9, come out at 10, again you go 11, come out at 1, and again 3:30. So 7 bites ideally should be taken. This is mistake number 1. Mistake number 2 is that, mistake number 1 is only 3-4 bites persisting is complete. No, don't do that. You take multiple. Why if you will take less, donut will not form. Mistake number 2 is you are taking deep bite like this. Do you know what will happen? Full thickness rectum will come and there will be severe rectal stricture, rectal perforation and death. Death is also reported. I will show you. If you will put the in the literature PPH stapler and death, there are many cases where patient has death also, resulted in patient death. FDA has warned it, procedure for prolapse hemorrhoid. It is a big problem. Stapled hemorrhoidopexy can even make the patient dead. And in the gynae patient, because there was severe perforation, pelvic abscess, peritonitis and death. Why? Because you have taken full thickness and then you staple rectum to rectum. You cut the rectum. In female, it has been reported to have rectovaginal fistula. This is a big complication which is life-threatening. Post-operative complication with the staple procedure can create rectovaginal fistula. Do you know why? Because rectovaginal fistula, surgeon, what he has done, he has not only taken rectum, he has taken a bite in the vagina also. And then fire. And then there is a communication established with the rectum to the vagina. So you should, how to prevent it? To prevent it, what you should do? You should not take a deep bite. Why deep bite sometimes is taken? That we keep our needle perpendicular to the mucosa. Don't do that. Keep the needle in parallel to the mucosa. You have to take only mucosa, submucosa. So on, how you know that this is mucosa? It will be moving. So only the muscle doesn't move. Mucosa, submucosa moves. And keep the needle parallel. Don't keep perpendicular. And then take a bite. So this is the second mistake, which can death also. So too deep bite. Another mistake, what we do, that we take like this, this way. What is the problem? You are small tucking the mucosa. So what will happen? If you just tuck the mucosa like that, when you tight the purse string, purpose of purse string is to bring the mucosa in between the anvil and gun. So once you do, it breaks. And it breaks like that. So what you do? You make a half donut. Because it is only a small bite, so it will cut through. And it will come a half donut. And half donut won't work. So this is third mistake. Now fourth mistake. Fourth mistake, what is done? That here is the rectum, here is the anal verge, and this is anal canal. Here is the anal canal. Now you have hemorrhoids. So suppose one hemorrhoid is here, one hemorrhoid is here, one is here, one is here, and one is prolapse here. Always you have to take a bite on the healthy mucosa, not on the hemorrhoid. Hemorrhoid, if you take a bite, it will bleed. So you have to take above the hemorrhoid over the healthy mucosa. But some people, what they do by mistake, that they take one bite here, 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 and then come out like this. So it make a zigzag, zigzag. It is not a purse string. Purse string should be that you should take a mucosal bite just above the highest hemorrhoid here, at this circle. That's why company has written it here. In this, you will see it is written 1, 2, 3, 4. Can you see that? Why it is written 1, 2, 3, 4 over this? Enoscope. This is called as enoscope. And see here it is written. Can you see that? 1, 2, 3, 4. Why they have written it? That if you have started at 4, continue all at 4. One hemorrhoid, one place you are going 5 cm deeper. Other place you are going 4 cm deeper. Third place you are 3 cm, 2 cm deeper. That will not make a purse string, it will make a zigzag string. And that will create avulsion. Once you tight it, if it is one here, other there, when you tight it, all break. All break. So all should be, abhi baitho aadha ghanta baithne ke liye, late kyun aaya hai? So all will break. And once it will break, then it will be like this. And this is not a purse string. This is bad. This is not a purse string. This is a map of Australia. So don't make it like this. It should be at the same circle at this level. This is the biggest mistake which we do. And then nothing comes. You fire the stapler, nothing comes out. So this is important. Now start the surgery. Purse string is started. Keep on rotating. Your assistant will keep on rotating the enoscope. And then you, this is now 5 o'clock position. 5 o'clock position, only mucosa, submucosa, this is the needle, only parallel to that. Here just recording is very difficult, that's why I am using here only one hand, because both the hand you cannot see anything. So recording of these areas is very difficult. But this is now 7 o'clock position. Hand of the light person is also occluding. Now, proline is better suture. Company gives you proline. Why? Proline is slippery, so it makes better purse string. And anyway, this proline will cut out with the gun as a donut. Now, this is 9 o'clock. There is one more important precaution. 7 and then one more precaution is that sometime what happens that this is enoscope and this is the enoscope is like that, and you have to rotate it 3, 5, 7, 9. Sometimes there is a big hemorrhoid like that, which is protruding inside. And if you will rotate, it will avulge. It will crush the hemorrhoid. So it is recommended not to directly rotate, take it out, rotate and push. So that it will not be crushed, it will not be avulged. So this is a small precaution has to be taken. So again it is 7 o'clock, then 9 o'clock. So I will take a little forward fast, all the clock you understood already. So this is now 9 o'clock, this is now 11 o'clock, and this is again, this is complete, 3 and a half. After that, what you do? Again, reintroduce at 9 o'clock, to take one simple bite at 9 o'clock. Do you know why? If the entire purse string is going like that and coming like this, starting and again coming out, and you pull it, only one side will be pulled more, other side will not be pulled more. I will give you one example. When you sit on the cupboard, and after that you stand up, and you have to put your trouser up, can you pull it by one hand? Have you tried it? If you pull by one hand, one side will come, other side will not come. So you need both your hands, both the sides. Isn't it? And then you pull it. With one hand you cannot wear a trouser. It will be very difficult. One side will be pulled, other side will be stuck with your buttock. So you need both your hands to bilateral symmetrically pulling it. That's why you have to make one more bite at 9 o'clock, so that you can bilaterally symmetrically pull it into the gun. And that's why in the gun you have two holes. If you will see, one hole is here on this side and other hole is there on that side. What is the purpose of this hole? That you go with the purse string with this knot puller and you have to pull it out. So there are, here if you see, there are four stitches, to this side, to that side. What is this? This one is pure purse string. And what is this? This is a simple bite. Simple bite. And now it is over. Your work is over now. Now you need to take a stapler, open the gun, put your finger to check that everything is going fine, and then slowly introduce it in. Right now purse string is not tight. You have to keep it loose. Purse string will be tightened once the anvil will go beyond the hemorrhoid. And slowly, slowly you are in. After that, you use suture puller. It should go up to this written fold. So the anvil should go beyond all the hemorrhoid. Virtually it enters into rectum. And after that, you pull it little out. Now anvil is anchored with the hemorrhoids. After that, you take the suture puller and entangle the suture into that and pull it out. You may tie a knot, some people they tie the knot, but tying the knot doesn't make purse string, pulling the knot make purse string. If you want, and this is pulled out. Here both of them pulled out this side. Again you put the suture puller from that side and pull these suture out, both of them, entangle it and pull it out. And here pulled out. After that, catch it one artery forceps here, then push it again in and keep on little pulling these, both of them. So you are bringing excess mucosa in this cup, and hemorrhoid also comes in this cup. All the four you can catch it with one artery forceps. Advantage is your one hand will be free. All the four you can clamp with one artery forceps and keep on giving little pressure. And then you will keep on closing the, closing the anvil. So right hand will rotate clockwise, anvil is coming. And this should be up to this four number. That means you are above the dentate line. If three or two is visible, that means you are out. And then you close, keep on closing it. And little traction on the mucosa should be keep on giving. And indicator should be keep on visible. Actually here, this is indicator. Here he has not taken a picture here. Can you see the indicator? This is the indicator visible. And then hold it by both the hand, catch it, and then you have to hold it like that, you have to fire. So keep it completely horizontal, 1, 2, 3 and fire. Here you catch it and fire. After firing, wait for 40 seconds. 40 seconds you have to wait so that all the hemostasis will develop. Here is the, can you see that? All the hemorrhoid is cut out. Here is the hemorrhoid which is cut out. And all the excess of the mucosa is cut. Now, how much big this donut you will get, depending upon how much loose mucosa was there in that patient. If patient has a lot of prolapse of the mucosa, you may get a donut of a size of a your belt of the trouser, that much. If less prolapse was there, only hemorrhoid was there, then it will be a size of a wristwatch belt. And if it is, there is no prolapse, only hemorrhoid, then it may become like a rubber band. But actually remember, this procedure is not recommended for grade 1 hemorrhoid. It should be grade 2 or grade 3 hemorrhoid. Because grade 1 hemorrhoid complication rate is more. So you have to be careful and this donut should be inspected. So very good, it is a full circle donut. Full circle donut and all the suture is also cut out. Now you will remove it and inspect all the hemorrhoid is there. So, this is hemorrhoid number 1, hemorrhoid number 2, hemorrhoid number 3, all is cut out. And it is cut as a mucosectomy. So, after that, you will check it. See here, everything is fine. You don't need to pack it. Some people, they take a packing. Packing, in my opinion, is bad. Packing creates more avulsion. Do you know why? A staple line get pressure. And a staple line has a bad effect that if one staple line is failure and you give the pressure, all will open. Just like one stitch is open, entire stitch can open. So don't do that. Pressure is not required. Just you swab it, check for bleeding. If bleeding is there, put the enoscope again and take a bite. Because you cannot fire second time. So this way PPH hemorrhoidectomy can be performed. Now, complications are not less. It has a lot of complications. Bleeding happens in 20% of the cases. Now, the bleeding happens, what to do? And why bleeding happens? Bleeding happens because you have taken a very thick, and it was a C, and it evolved, bleeding started. So, check the bleeding during surgery itself. If post-operative bleeding happens, then it is difficult to manage. Some people who are there, pack it with a big sponge or bandage, entire bandage, they push it. What is the problem? It will break the further gap in between the proximal and distal mucosa. It will push the mucosa of rectal side towards the rectum, anal side, and there is a raw area. And patient, after few hours, will feel like defecating. You will remove the pack, he go to the commode, and he will defecate 1 liter blood. And typically fainted in the bathroom itself, toilet itself. Nurse will lift and bring. Don't do that. What you do, you take this post-operatively if you have the bleeding, introduce it inside and there is a hole. Through this hole you put a Foley's catheter and inflate a balloon inside the rectum and then pull it and then pack it. That tamponade effect of Foley's from rectum towards outside will not allow the avulsion and not allow the blood to go to the rectum. And then bring the patient to the OT, and if you can see, put it and then stitch it. So this is a big mistake, and most of these mistakes happen due to bad persisting. So this is 20% of the cases it happens. Pain is another problem. Why pain is? Your obturator was outside protruded, and when you take your donut below the dentate line. And below the dentate line you have nerve endings. Then pain lasting for more than 6 months, 5%, urinary retention 3%, tenesmus 5%, thrombosis sometime, recurrence 6%, and presenting with one or more complication is 26%. And most of these complications are technique related. What technique we are using, it depends upon that. And most important technique is taking persisting. If your persisting is good, consistency is there. And all the four mistakes which I have done, I have told you, less bite, deeper bite, thinner bite, and zigzag bite. Don't do that. Take a proper persisting so that a good donut will form. And after surgery, you must inspect the donut and then check the bleeding if it is there, then and there. So this was regarding the PPH stapler. Any question? You can apply for? Yes, of course. No, which type of rectal surgery you have done previously? You know, before doing it, I will suggest you do the per rectal examination with the gloves and see that mucosa is free. There should not be any fibrosis. If there is any fibrosis in the PR, then you should not go. But if you see mucosa is loose, then you can perform. Yes?
Professor Mishra, actually I have some comment, maybe separation and some questionable price.
Yes?
By definition of hemorrhoid, it is an exaggeration of the inner cushion, that is exaggeration of inner penis lead after the penis restoration and more smooth muscle. Because remember that one of West European countries companies came to our country and with their devices and surgeon take with us days to explain how to use a stapler. And after that we start to practice this form of surgery, but later on our senior professor in the GI said we stop doing such a procedure because something related to that procedure. Yes, cosmetic it is accepted, no way. And even if you leave the inner cushion inside, then the continuous of the inner canal is maintained.
Yes.
The problem, we use this devices which is very expensive and cannot be available anywhere in advanced form of hemorrhoids. And we see that what we do is that it's only excising the mucosa above the exaggerated inner cushion. That's hemorrhoidopexy.
Yes.
And still, what is written in the reference, hemorrhoidectomy is the gold standard management.
You are absolutely correct. I will tell you one simple thing.
My question is that
yes.
With excision of mucosa and doing its stable along the mucosa, there may be a major risk for extension.
Of course, if you will take a muscle together, there will be a stricture. If you will take muscle and serosa, there may be death. There may be rectal perforation. There may be rectovaginal fistula. So that already I have told you. But one thing I will tell you. Any surgery, if it has too many technique of doing, that means none of them are good. Obviously. Any surgery, if you have too many methods, that means still gold standard has not arrived. And you are absolutely correct, this is not a good surgery. This is not a good surgery, it has a lot of criticism and it is not a gold standard. But if you will little take care of the proper persisting, that some patient, and it is not a new surgery, it is more than 20 years. Old procedure, PPH stapler. But still it is surviving. Still it has not been banned by FDA. Still it is not contraindicated to do. So complication rates are there, but in the patient who will demand for, you have to do it. Isn't it? But it is, you are absolutely correct, it gold standard, this is not a gold standard. Gold standard is conventional hemorrhoidectomy. That is, you are correct.